الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah, Lord of the worlds, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon the noble Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companions. أما بعد, thereafter, فيا أيها الإخوة الكرام, my dear brothers and sisters, لا زلنا في صدد الحديث عن علامات الساعة الصغرى التي تكلم عنها سيدنا النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. We are still in the process of talking about the minor signs that are indicative that the day of judgment is near, as related to us by our master, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his family and his companions. أيها الإخوة الكرام, my dear brothers and sisters, اعلموا رحمكم الله, know, may Allah have mercy on you, أن الإمام أحمد روى في مسنده عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. الإمام أحمد related in his book المسند from the route of أبو هريرة, may Allah be pleased with him, قال, he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger of Allah peace be upon him said, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتقارب الزمان. He said, the hour will not happen until time becomes so short. فتكون السنة كالشهر. 1 year will be equivalent to a month. ويكون الشهر كالجمعة. And a month will become short as if it were only a week. وتكون الجمعة كاليوم. And then 1 week will be as short as a day. ويكون اليوم كالساعة. And 1 day will be so short, it would seem like it was only an hour. وتكون الساعة كاحتراق السعفة. And that hour will seem so short, like the time it would take for a branch of a palm tree to burn. Just few minutes. ففي هذا الحديث الشريف يبين لنا صلى الله عليه وسلم علامة من علامات قيام الساعة الصغرى. So then in this hadith, the messenger peace be upon him and his family and his companions clarified for us this particular sign and talked about this sign that will happen indicative of the hour being near. وهي تقارب الزمان. And as we mentioned, this sign is time will seem very short. وتقارب الزمان قد يكون بذهاب بركة الوقت. When we talk about time passing by so fast that it seems short, it could be that the blessings are lifted off time. وهذا قد وقع منذ عصر بعيد. This actually happened a long time ago. قال ابن حجر وقد وجد في زماننا هذا. الإمام ابن حجر stated that at his time this did exist. فإننا نجد من سرعة مر الأيام ما لم يكن نجده في العصر الذي قبل عصرنا هذا. Ibn Hajar, may Allah be pleased with him, said, the way we are seeing time pass by so fast these days, the days are passing by so fast, this is something that we did not witness in the era that came before us. فمن معاني تقارب الزمان سرعة الأيام والشهور والأعوام. So then, when you talk about time being short, you could see this in the days passing by quickly, the months passing by quickly, the years passing by quickly as well. فَمَا تُشْرِقُ شَمْسُ يَوْمٍ إِلَّا وَتَغْرُبُ. In general, the sun rises and then it sets. وَلَا يَهِلُّ شَهْرٌ إِلَّا وَيُدْبِرُ. Similarly, a month comes by and before you know it, you're in the next one. It passes by fast. وَلَا تَبْتَدِئُ سَنَةٌ إِلَّا وَتَنْقَضِي سَرِيعًا. More so, the whole year comes by and before you know it, we're moving on to the next one. وَقَدْ نُزِعَتِ الْبَرَكَةُ مِنَ الْأَوْقَاتِ وَالْأَرْزَاقِ وَالْأَعْمَارِ. Reason being is because blessings have been removed from time. Also, in so many cases, sustenance has been diminished and age has been cut down. وَمِن مَعَانِي تَقَارُبِ الزَّمَانِ أَنَّ الْوَاحِدَ مِنَّا لَا يَكَادُ يَبْتَدِئُ نَهَارَهُ فَإِذَا بِهِ يَنْتَهِي. On a personal level, you will see that you get up, you start your day, and before you know it, it's almost over. وَهَذِهِ الْعَلَامَةُ مِنْ عَلَامَاتِ السَّاعَةِ مِنْ أَوْضَحِ الْعَلَامَاتِ وَأَظْهَرِهَا الْيَوْمِ. This particular sign of time being short is of the clearest signs that are indicative that the hour is near. إِذْ إِنَّنَا نَشْهَدُ وُقُوعَهَا الْيَوْمِ وَنَرَاهَا وَاضِحَةً جَلِيَّةً. We are witnessing it taking place today and it is crystal clear. واضحة جلية, very evident. فالوقت يمر على الناس بصورة سريعة. So now time is going across people so fast. تدعو للدهشة. Something that is astonishing to see and witness. والتأمل. And this should call for reflection. فلا بركة في الوقت. We realize there is not much blessings in time anymore. حَتَّى يُخَيَّلُ إِلَى الْوَاحِدِ أَنَّ السَّنَةَ كَالشَّهْرِ وَالشَّهْرَ كَالْأُسْبُوعِ وَالْأُسْبُوعَ كَالْيَوْمِ وَالسَّاعَةَ كَوَقْتِ احْتِرَاقِ خُوصَةِ النَّخْلِ. كما ورد في الحديث, each one who takes a moment will see that time is going so fast that a year seems like it's only a month seems like it's only a week seems like only a day, and a day is just minutes long enough to take for a branch of a palm tree to burn. وَحَدِيثُ كِبَارِ السِّنِّ فِي مَجَالِسِهِمْ. When you listen to the elderly talk in their sessions, أنهم كانوا ينجزون في يومهم وليلتهم أعمالا كثيرة. They will tell you, or you will hear them say, that back in the day, they used to accomplish so much in the course of a day and a night. يعجزون اليوم عن إنجازها في أسبوع كامل. They couldn't possibly do the same thing and achieve the same thing even in the course of a week today. وكانت أرزاق الناس قليلة جدا ولكنها كانت تكفيهم. These elders will tell you that they didn't have much back then, but it was sufficient to suffice all of them. ويتصدقون منها ويدخرون. Not only was it sufficient for them, they used to give some of it in charity and keep some aside. فَلَمَّا اتَّسَعَتْ أَرْزَاقُهُمْ وتهيأت لهم سبل المواصلات والاتصالات. Then, as they moved on and sustenance became abundant and transportation has changed where it became so rapid for one to move from one place to another, والاتصالات and the way they communicate and we communicate, وتتابعت النعم عليهم, and then successively sustenance kept coming and coming and coming, حتى نزعت البركة من أوقاتهم وأرزاقهم. They will tell you that they feel the blessings have been removed from their time and their sustenance. وروى الشيخان عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, الإمام البخاري and الإمام مسلم, may Allah be pleased with them, related from the route of Abu Huraira, he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, he said, the messenger of Allah, peace be upon him and his family and his companions, said, يتقارب الزمان, he said, time will become short, ويقبض العلم, and knowledge will be captured and removed, وتظهر الفتن, and there will be tribulations everywhere, ويلقى الشح, and people will be stingy, and there will be little shared among each other, ويكثر الهرج, and there will be so much هرج. قالوا وما الهرج, they asked the Prophet, peace be upon him, what is harj? قال القتل, he said, crime, people killing other people. وفي رواية للإمام البخاري رضي الله عنه عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, and a narration of Al-Imam Al-Bukhari, may Allah be pleased with him, he related from the route of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him as well, قال, he said, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, Abu Huraira said, the messenger of Allah, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him and his family and his companions, said, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقبض العلم, he said, the hour will not take place until knowledge is captured and removed from this nation. وتكثر الزلازل, and all of the sudden you will see so many earthquakes taking place so often. ويتقارب الزمان, this is where he mentions it, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, and time becomes short. وتظهر الفتن, he said, there will be so much tribulation. ويكثر الهرج, وهو القتل, القتل, the Prophet said, and then you will have so much harj, and he said, it is crime, killing, killing, حتى يكثر فيكم المال فيفيض, and wealth will be given to you in such abundance, and that is not necessarily a good thing, because هذه النعمة تنقلب نقمة, this blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes a trial, a problem for people, because they don't handle money properly, and we'll get into that at a later time. أما عن تقارب الزمان, let's expound about this issue of time becoming short. قال الله تعالى والعصر, Allah Most High said والعصر, it's an oath he made by time, and the word عصر in the Arabic language has several meanings, one of which, as explained by the ulama, by the scholars, is that it refers to the time that's passing fast. Because when you say عصر, ما يتبادر إلى الذهن, What comes to mind is the time of Asr where the sun is about to set, declaring the day is almost over, see? Similarly, the meaning then becomes, as said by the scholars, that time is passing by fast. يُنذِرُ بِقُدُومِ السَّاعَ. It's warning that the hour is near. قال الفضيل بن عياض رحمه الله تعالى لرجل. الفضيل بن عياض, may Allah be pleased with him, one time said to a man, كم أتت عليك؟ How old are you? قال ستون سنة. The man replied, 60 years. قال فأنت منذ ستين سنة تسير إلى ربك يوشك أن تبلغ. He said, so for 60 years, you are moving towards your Lord. That is to say, you are closer and closer to death where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you. And you're almost there, he said. يوشك أن تبلغ. He said, you're almost there. فقال الرجل, the man responded, إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Indeed, to Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. قال الفضيل, الفضيل then said to him, أتعرف تفسيره؟ He said, do you know what that means? تقول إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. He said, you just said, to Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. Do you know the meaning of this statement? فمن علم أنه لله عبد وأنه إليه راجع فليعلم أنه موقوف. He said, the one who knows and recognizes that he is the servant of Allah and to Allah he shall return, he needs to know, let him know, فَلْيَعْلَمْ, let him know that he is gonna be stopped. He is gonna be standing. He is going to be positioned. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ. And the one who recognizes that he's gonna be standing in a particular post, let him know he's gonna be there, so he will be questioned. He's gonna be judged on the day of judgment. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ فَلْيُعِدَّ لِلسُّؤَالِ جَوَابًا. He said, and now that the servant recognizes that he is going to be questioned, then let him prepare the answers for the questions he's going to be asked about. قَالَ الرَّجُلُ, the man became concerned and he said, فَمَا الْحِيلَةُ قَالَ يَسِيرًا. He said, what's the solution? He said, it's easy. قال ما هي? He said, what is it? Tell me. قال تحسن فيها. تحسن فيما بقي يغفر لك ما مضى. He said, with what you got left of your age, perform well, do good deeds, and by virtue of your doing, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive things that were done in the past. فَإِنَّكَ إِنْ أَسَأْتَ فِي مَا بَقِيَ أُخِذْتَ بِمَا مَضَى وَمَا بَقِيَ. مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ. How wise. He said to him, if you don't do well with what is left of your age and you do evil deeds, then when you are taken, أُخِذْتَ, you're gonna be taken to death by the angels. You will be taken with what passed and with what you got left. So you gotta do well. أيها الإخوة الكرام, my dear brothers and sisters, لقد اختلف الفقهاء رضي الله عنهم في معنى تقارب الزمن إلى عدة أقوال. The scholars, when they discussed this issue of time being short, they had various opinions about it. And I will list them shortly, inshallah, and in brief. أما القول الأول, as for the first one, the first opinion, وهو قول ابن حجر والقاضي عياض رضي الله عنهما. Here you have one opinion of time being short by Al-Imam Ibn Hajar and Al-Qadi Iyad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on them both. قالوا, these two stated, أن المراد بذلك قلة البركة في الزمان. They said, when you talk about time being short, he said, blessings will be removed from time. So you're not able to achieve as much in the course of a day like you used to in the past. يقول ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى. Take a look at this. الإمام ابن حجر, may Allah be pleased with him, said, قد وجد في زماننا هذا. He said, this is happening now at our age. فَإِنَّا نَجِدُ مِنْ سُرْعَةِ مَرِّ الْأَيَّامِ مَا لَمْ نَكُنْ نَجِدُهُ فِي الْعَصْرِ الَّذِي قَبْلَ عَصْرِنَا هَذَا. He said, what we are seeing and witnessing concerning time and how fast it's passing, this is something we have not seen previously. وَالْقَوْلُ الثَّانِي, as for the second opinion, وهو قول الخطابي رحمه الله تعالى. This is the statement of Al-Imam Al-Khattabi, may Allah be pleased with him. أن المراد بذلك ما يكون في زمن المهدي عليه السلام. He said, when the issue of time being short is addressed, Al-Imam Al-Khattabi, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, this is in reference to the time where Al-Mahdi will come. وَزَمَنِ سَيِّدِنَا عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. He has a totally different opinion. He said, this is in reference to when Al-Mahdi comes and our Master Jesus, peace be upon him. وَذَلِكَ لِأَنَّ النَّاسَ يَسْتَلِذُّونَ بِالْعَيْشِ. He said, because at that time, people will bask in a good life. They will bask in the glory, the bounty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them. وَتَوَفُّرِ الْأَمْنِ. And there will be such safety. وَانْتِشَارِ الْعَدْلِ. And justice will be spread out throughout the land everywhere. فَيَسْتَقْصِرُ النَّاسُ مُدَّةَ أَيَّامِ الرَّخَاءِ وَإِنْ طَالَتْ. He said, people at that time will see time being short, even if it was not. Because يَسْتَلِذُّونَ بِمَا فِيهِمْ. They are so enjoying the blessings that Allah Ta'ala gives them by the presence of Jesus, peace be upon him and his mother, that they don't realize that the days are what they are. To them, it seems like the days are short. وَتَطُولُ عَلَيْهِمْ مُدَّةُ الشِّدَّةِ وَالْبُؤْسِ وَإِنْ قَصُرَتْ. He said, similarly, when they are under duress, they feel that the time is so much longer, even if it were shorter. So based on their perception of the state they are in, if they are in a bounty, they will see it to be passing by fast. The days are short. And if they are under duress, it would seem to them by their perception that, oh, when will this go away? They will feel like it's taken long. أما القول الثالث, as for the third opinion, وهو قول الداودي أن المراد بذلك تقارب ساعات الليل والنهار. الداودي, may Allah be pleased with him, also he has a different opinion. It goes to show you, these people are scholars. they see of the same element so many various interpretations, because they are so up there in knowledge. May Allah Ta'ala bring us to their status. Ameen. So Ad-Dawoodi said, what is meant by time being short or passing by fast? He said, this is in reference to night and day. This is in reference to night and day. فَتَقْصُرُ سَاعَاتُ النَّهَارِ قَبْلَ قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ وَيَقْرُبُ النَّهَارُ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. This is so beautiful. He said, the nights, the hours in the night time get so close to the day, that is, nighttime falls before you know it, the next day is here, and vice versa. He said, so the hours of the day become very short before day of judgment. وَيَقْرُبُ النَّهَارُ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. Daytime gets so close to the nighttime. Now you gotta remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. It is during the daytime that you do things, including earning your living, earning a living. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ سُبَاتًا. Allah Ta'ala made the nighttime for rest. So it is during the daytime that things get done. At least it's supposed to be this way. This is the proper Islamic way. So when daytime becomes this short, people have less of an opportunity to perform. And this is significant. This is why we cannot afford to take a minute and send it to waste. We gotta work all the time to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أما القول الرابع, as for the fourth opinion, أن المراد بذلك هو تقارب أحوال أهله من قلة الدين أو في قلة الدين. سبحان الله, this is fascinating how each one of these scholars saw it differently. Some scholars said, when you talk about time being short, this is in reference not so much to time itself, but to the similarity of the state of the people between one people and the next. They are so similar in their state. What state is that? قَالَ فِي قِلَّةِ الدِّينِ, that their religion will be diminished. حَتَّى لَا يَكُونُ فِيهِمْ مَنْ يَأْمُرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, until there will be none left who command good deeds and prohibit evil deeds. لِغَلَبَةِ الْفِسْقِ وَظُهُورِ أَهْلِهِ. And the reason being is, there will be so much sin, and the people who are sinners become common and dominant and prevalent. وَالْقَوْلُ الْخَامِسِ, as for the fifth opinion, أن المراد بذلك تقارب أهل الزمان في طي الزمان والمسافات, وذلك بسبب وفرة وسائل المواصلات والاتصالات, وذلك بتقدم وتطور الوسائل. The fifth opinion, they said, time will be called short because people will be able to transport and move from one place to another, covering great distances, and they do so in a very short period of time. And this is due to the advancement of technology and the like. التي منها النقل البري والجوي والبحري حتى فاق بعضها سرعة الصوت. Like what you see today, the way people transport merchandise across the oceans, or the way they travel from one place to another by flying in an airplane, or even when moving across the land in a car or the like, it's done in such a speedy manner. and you want to talk about speed, حتى فاق منها سرعة الصوت. Some of these jets that can fly, they can exceed the speed of sound. Subhanallah. That's one part of it. That's a subcategory of the fifth opinion. As for the second one, B, هو تطور وسائل الإعلام من مسموع ومرئي. This has to do with the media, the way they broadcast things, whether it is by radio or by television. فصارت الأخبار تنتقل من مواقع الحدث مباشرة. Whatever event takes place, they broadcast it immediately. You can see it in real time across the land. تنقل الحروب والخطابات والحفلات وغير ذلك مباشرة. They broadcast things that pertain to wars, lectures, celebrations, among other things, and they do that directly in real time. ولو كان ذلك في أقصى بلاد العالم, even if this happened to be in the farthest place on earth. بل زاد الأمر بعدا عندما نقلت الشاشات العالمية نزول الإنسان على سطح القمر. If you recall, or if you're not that old, you will know at least that people across the world, planet Earth, were watching when the first man landed on the moon. That was one of the first events to be broadcasted worldwide where everybody watched it. ومن هنا قيل العالم قرية صغيرة. This is where the expression came about, where people said, the world indeed is a small village. أما القول السادس. So, the sixth opinion is, وهو قول ابن أبي حمزة, ابن أبي جمرة رحمه الله تعالى. May Allah ease my tongue. The sixth opinion is the opinion of Ibn Abi Jamra, may Allah have mercy on him. قال إن المراد بذلك إما حسي وإما معنوي. He said what is meant by time being short, this is either something that's sensual, in the sense that you feel, وإما معنوي, or it's something that is allegorical. أما الحسي فلم يظهر بعد. He said that which is physical, that you sense and see by one of your senses, it hasn't happened yet. ولعله من الأمور التي تكون قرب الساعة. الإمام ابن أبي حمزة رضي الله عنه, he said this is something perhaps that will happen towards the very end of time when the hour is just about to take place. وأما المعنوي, he said as for the one that is on the spiritual realm, he said, فَلَهُ مُدَّةٌ مُنْذُ ظَهَرْ. He said, it has already come out and it's been a while. يَعْرِفُ ذَلِكَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ فِي الدِّينِ. He said, the people who have knowledge of the religion recognize that. Subhanallah. وَمَنْ لَهُ فِتْنَةٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ السَّبَبِ الدُّنْيَوِي. And also the clever person who is aware of the mundane gain, who is watchful of how wealth is changing. قلت, the Imam said, فإن أريد به نزع البركة وقصر الأعمار فهذا حاصل في هذا الزمان. He said, if one wants to say, no, this is in reference to blessings being removed and people living for a shorter period of time because they get very sick and die or whatever reason. He said, فهذا حاصل في هذا الزمان. This is already taking place. It's happening. بل قبله بكثير. Not only that, it happened a long time ago. وإن لم يصل إلى حد ما ذكر في الحديث. Even if it did not reach the degree which is mentioned in the prophetic tradition. وإن أريد به القصر الزمني الحسي فهذا لم يقع بعد. He said, if you are talking about the physicality of time being short, time literally being short, this has not happened yet. ولعله يكون في آخر الزمان. He said, perhaps this will happen towards the end of time. والقول السابع, the seventh opinion, وهو قول الإمام الطحاوي رحمه ورضي الله عنه. It's the statement of الإمام الطحاوي, may Allah show him mercy and be pleased with him. قال الإمام الطحاوي said أن المراد بذلك تساوي الناس في جهلهم. He said in that what is meant is people will become equal in their ignorance والعياذ بالله. وذلك بترك طلب العلم. يا الله, to me, I want to stick with this opinion, my humble self. He said, this is because people abandon knowledge, seeking knowledge, the knowledge of this deen, religion. والرضا بالجهل, rather they accept ignorance. لأن الأصل أنهم لا يتساوون في العلم, فالعلم درجات. He said, to begin with, they're not equal when it comes to knowledge, because knowledge has various degrees. قال تعالى, Allah Most High said, وفوق كل ذي علم عليم. Above every knowledgeable person, there is one who is more knowledgeable. وإنما يتساوى الناس في الجهل. So then, the opinion of Al-Imam Al-Tahawi, he said, people will become equal on one platform, the platform of ignorance. And we seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from it. لأنه درجة واحدة. Because ignorance has only one level, and they all stoop to that level. أيها الإخوة الكرام, my dear brothers and sisters, قال البعض أن أصح الأقوال في معنى تقارب الزمان هو قلة بركة الزمان كما جاء في الحديث الشريف فتكون السنة كالشهر. So many of the scholars went with the opinion that when you talk about time being short, this is in reference to the blessings being removed from time itself. So a year would seem like a month, as mentioned in the prophetic tradition. والسبب في قلة البركة هو ظهور المعاصي والمنكرات. The reason why the blessings are removed from time is because sins become dominant and people will do things تنكروا عليهم, that you denounce. You're like, أعوذ بالله, how can they be doing this? منكرات. وخاصة أكل الربا, especially consuming usury, consuming money that's from usury. If you recall, in one of my lectures concerning this topic, I said the financial international institution that's put in place around the world today is all illa man rahim Allah, except the whom Allah showed mercy to, based on usury. I said that. And usury is bound to collapse, and you are seeing the beginning of it. It's all on the decline. From here, it's all downhill. Don't be fooled by Wall Street and the numbers jumping up and up and up and up. What goes up must come down, and it is going down. And when it does, it's gonna crash at once. Not that I'm wishing on it or upon it. نرجو الخير للجميع. We wish well for everybody in the halal means. But I want you to know that The reason why Allah Ta'ala removes blessings from time is because of the prevalence of sins and acts that are so despicable in disobeying Allah, particularly, especially usury, al-riba. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala declared war on the people who deal with riba. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, that was in the Quran. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala declared war in the Hadith al-Qudsi on those who take the awliya of Allah as enemies. And these are the only two known cases where Allah Ta'ala declared war against the people who deal with usury and against those who take the awliya of Allah as enemies. We seek refuge with Allah from that. War rashwa. Rashwa is when you pay somebody who's not supposed to be paid to get you something done. There's a name for it in English. I can't think of it right now. Subhanallah. وَأَكْلَ مَالِ الْيَتِيمِ ظُلْمًا. And consuming the money of the orphan, and to do that unjustly. وَأَكْلَ أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ بِالْبَاطِلِ بِشَكْلٍ عَامٍ. And to consume the monies of the people in a manner which is unjust in general. وَهَذَا هُوَ الْمُشَاهَدُ فِي وَاقِعِنَا الْمَرِيرِ. This is the bitter reality in which we are living today. حيث صدق في واقعنا حديث سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So now you see manifest the statement of the master, our master, the messenger of Allah, peace be upon him and his family and his companions. قال, he said, يأتي على الناس زمان يأكلون الربا. He said there will come a time where people will consume riba, usury. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَأْكُلْهُ أَصَابَهُ مِنْ غُبَارِهِ. Even if one is not consuming riba, he will get to consume from its dust because it's so spread everywhere. رواه النسائي عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. This hadith was related from the route of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him. وقص على ذلك المعاصي والمنكرات التي تفشت في المجتمع من عقوق الوالدين. In addition to that, all across the land, add to that all types of sins and despicable acts which have spread in the society, especially عقوق الوالدين, being disobedient to the parents. وسوء تربية الأبناء. Nobody is raising their kids properly anymore إلا من رحم الله, except those whom Allah Ta'ala have mercy on them. وسفك الدماء, shedding blood. وسلب الأموال, stealing money. والظلم الشديد, extreme injustice in the way that people are treated. وإلى الله تعالى المشتكى. I turned to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, complaining to him about this with the intent that he may change it insha'Allah. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ. اللَّهُمَّ رُدَّنَا إِلَيْكَ رَدًّا جَمِيلًا. Oh Allah, turn us back to you